I'm George Jennings in the mathematics department, and I've been teaching using free textbooks for a number of years in linear algebra classes, currently in my calculus for life sciences classes and advanced analysis classes. It turns out that there are a number of people who have produced free textbooks. Some of them have written free textbooks, you know, expressly for that purpose. Others have received the copyright back from the publisher and have been able to make their textbooks available for free. So there are a number of these things available in the mathematics area. But there are a number of issues involved with these things. So their advantages to free textbooks are, first of all, that they're widely available. They're free, anybody can download them. They often have a community of users associated with them. So just like software people who are designing free computer programs, often the writers of free textbooks will kind of encourage other people to send in ideas to their websites, they'll add them to their websites, and so over a period of time, a lot of materials will develop that are associated with the textbook, and other people have contributed. So the fact that it's free kind of encourages people to do this. And another thing that's good about them is they're often updated rapidly, because the authors are still involved with them, and they're trying to improve them all the time. There are also disadvantages involved with free textbooks. They're not reviewed by reviewers. They are not edited. And so the author, if the author's a very good writer, that's fine, but it's hard to edit your own stuff. And so they can have varying quality. Some of the materials are not very good, and some of them really are quite good. Students perceive, I've asked my students about, how do they like using free textbooks. And there's a perception among students that since they didn't pay for it, it's really not worth very much. So that is actually an issue. I found this very surprising, because I know the quality of the people who are writing these books, and I know they're, at least the ones that I've used, really quite good. But the students will say, if it's free, it's a throwaway. And so this is part of an issue. Another issue that comes up is some free books are available only online. The only way that you can read them is by looking at a computer screen. And this is actually rather harder to do than to read a paper book. Even for young people, I think this is hard. And if you try to read it on the phone, this is especially hard. But to mitigate this, there are a lot of free textbooks will publish with publishers like Lulu, who produce books for incredibly low prices. So, for instance, I'm using now a calculus for a life sciences book, which is something like $18, and it's a huge book. It's a really high quality book. In fact, I think this book is as high quality or higher than any other book I've seen in this area, available from a commercial publisher or not. It was written by some faculty at the University of Iowa who taught a calculus for life sciences course for a long time, and it's just an outstanding book. And you can download it if you want, and you can read it on your computer, or you can get a copy from Lulu for a very cheap price. So one of the other issues that I mentioned with these books is that they tend not to be reviewed and not to be edited. So the American Institute of Mathematics has tried to address this issue by collecting together a group of people who will systematically review free textbooks and then write things about them. And so you can use this resource if you're teaching mathematics, to help decide which books you want to use. So let me just point for a second to this thing. The American Institute of Mathematics is So it's www.aims.org. So I'm sorry, it's not AIMS, it's AI, it's American Institute of Math, it's AIMMath.org. And I think I put that up there before. So if you go to projects, there's an open textbook initiative. I happen to be a member of the editorial group, or the people who review these textbooks. So let me just show you a few. few of the textbooks that have been approved by this group, and you can see the range of different topics that are available. So we have here a bunch of different things that this group of reviewers, there's five of us from different universities around the country who are actively reviewing these books, and so you see there are calculus books. Some of these books were originally published by publishers. So for instance, this one was published by Springer Verlagen and still is, but they've also made it available for free, and so we reviewed it. It's really an excellent book. This is a very famous book by Hilbert Strang that was also published by a commercial publisher, and then I think he was the commercial publisher. He has his own company, but then he made it available for free. This is a book that was written specifically to be used, you know, just to be available for free. It's a guy at Whitman College, and he's been updating it continuously and making all sorts of things, adding all sorts of things to it. So it's got a community of users. And then the book that I'm using right now in my Calculus for Life Sciences book is this one called Calculus for Life Sciences. So let me just click to him. Let's see. So we've got. There's a review of it. There's a bunch of information. And then if you want to download this book, this thing links to the page of the author's webpage where he has a website in which he's put all of his materials here. You can download. You can look at different chapters one at a time, or you could download the whole book if you want, and it's quite high quality. I mean, the way this thing is produced, it's a good quality math book. It's nicely typeset. There's very good typesetting available for mathematics software also for free, and it's got, you know, they've got graphics and illustrations. See, I have one up here. So you see, I mean, he's incorporated graphics and illustrations and all sorts of things, and it's got exercises, and you know, it's the whole shebang. So when we evaluate textbooks, there are a number of criteria that we expect the textbook to, you know, in order to get our approval, the textbook has to satisfy. One, it has to be free and well written. It has to be it has to at least appear to have been proofread by somebody, so that there's not a lot of errors in it or anything like that. You know, that the words are spelled right and this sort of thing. And it has to be suitable for using in an ordinary university class, so that the coverage, the type of coverage, has to cover a course. And you know, a sort of a standard course. If it's something really weird, then we won't approve it, because what we're expecting is that these are books that we should be able to recommend them to our colleagues and say, this is a good book to look at for your course. And we also expect it to be class tested. So then, and ideally, it should have been used by somebody else besides the author. And so we try to get some information from the other people that used it to see how well it works. I don't know whether in other areas besides mathematics there are groups like this, but there may be. And if there aren't, then I would encourage you to form one. So if you use free books to try to get evaluations of them up, because one of the big impediments that people have towards using free books is, you know, if you go out, on Google or if you go out, I mean, Merlot helps with this a lot, because Merlot has, they do have comments that people have made about what the materials are, and they try to classify things. The new version of Merlot will say whether it's a textbook or not. And so that's quite helpful. A lot of the books that we have reviewed are on the Merlot site. So that can be helpful. But you can go further than that by actually having people do formal reviews of them. And that helps you to choose a lot. Why do you spend all my time?
Okay.
All right. So I wanted to say one more thing, that one of the things that people look for when they're choosing books, at least in mathematics classes, besides homework, and this is another thing, is that our books, all the books that we review have to have homework exercises and the whole sort of stuff that you'd expect to have in a textbook. But one of the things a publisher supply is they'll supply websites which have online homework systems. And so, you know, these are homework systems that will deliver homework problems to students, and then the students can type in solutions, and then they'll grade them and do all this kind of stuff. So this is a completely different level this is quite different than writing a book. This is a lot of computer software and stuff. But it turns out in the mathematics world anyway, there is something like that too. So the Mathematical Association of America, the MAA, has sponsored something called WebWork, which supplies a free homework system for people to use in mathematics classes. They have 29,000 problems uploaded onto this thing that have been written by other people. They're algorithmically generated problems. And I've been using these problems for at least 12 years. And the system works quite well. You install it on a server on your campus. It's installed on the server here. And we use it in calculus classes and in your algebra classes, differential equations, and some other things. So it enables students to be able to or enables instructors to deliver homework problems for students. These are drill-type problems, right? And then the students can type in their answers to it, and it will immediately tell them whether their answer is correct or incorrect. And sometimes, depending on the quality of the problem, it will tell them, it will give them hints about, you know, what could be wrong with their answer, and you know how they can make it better. So students at first resist this kind of thing, but at the end of the course, I've always heard from my students that they really appreciate it. Because of the immediate feedback that it gives them. So that's what we're
doing. Mr. George?
Anybody have any questions on any of this stuff? I could show you a WebWork problem if you want, but you've all probably seen math problems.